GCC East Bay community. I'm Brianna Summer. I'm the Director of Youth and Teen Programs at the GCC East Bay. And we are very excited to announce our first ever live challah making that will be happening on Friday, May 8th in the afternoon. So please mark your calendars. We're going to have it live both on Zoom and streaming through our Facebook. So check out at GCC East Bay for more information on that. To help you prepare, I also need to introduce my incredible co-pilot in our baking process, Chef Lana. Please introduce yourself.
Hi, my name's Lana. I'm a chef teacher at JCC East Bay in Berkeley. I make all the food for the kids, all the snack. And I'm going to be helping this summer, and I'll be doing a vegan challah.
Thank you so much, Lana. So we're going to quickly go through the ingredients you will need for this. So hopefully you can schedule it in. I know we're trying to stay at home as much as possible. So when you do need to go to the market, these are some things to keep in mind that you'll need. The first most important thing is active yeast. So this is pretty crucial. I know it's something that's pretty hard to find in stores. If you want, you can either do individual packets. We also, I know on Amazon, sells kind of like bulk active yeast. So definitely would recommend having that. Lana, I'm pretty sure also we both, for the vegan and for the regular recipe, you definitely need active yeast. Great.
Definitely need yeast.
The next thing you'll need, for sure, if you're making any bread, is flour. So I'm using just normal all-purpose flour. If you want to make your challah a little bit healthier, you're welcome to add in some whole wheat flour. And if you wanted to make a gluten-free version, we can adapt and accommodate with gluten-free flour as well. So definitely need flour. Next thing is canola oil or vegetable oil. So this is going to help make it nice and moist. And for Lana,
I got vegan butter. You can also use oil if you want. I like vegan butter in it. I think it adds a nice texture.
Fantastic. Okay. Next we have sugar, classic.
Also have sugar.
Brilliant. We have some lovely, I only have sea salt. I do not have kosher salt. I'm very bummed. I wish I did, but I'm using sea salt.
This is the last type of kosher salt at the grocery store. Usually I use Diamond Kosher. This is not at all, you know, Diamond Kosher approved for me to say, but that's the only kosher salt I usually cook with, but this is fine.
We will adapt. Next we have eggs. So my recipe will call for 3 eggs. If you're concerned about your egg consumption, if you need to use less, we can always have the recipes. So 3 eggs is what we're going to be going for.
I use aquafaba, which is the liquid from a can of chickpeas. I usually whip that first, but I'll show you in the video how I do that. But it's a very good vegan egg replacement.
And that's pretty much it. The only thing left that I have on my table are things that are toppings. So I've got our awesome everything bagel topping, which can be a fun, yummy additional topping for your challah. We've got chocolate chips because why not? And if you want to just continue with your sea salt, just give it a little bit of flavor. You're welcome to do that too. Or cinnamon sugar, or there's raisins. Everyone's got their own fave toppings. So feel free to bring those along for Friday, May 8th. And we're so excited to see you all for our live challah baking. So thanks everyone. Hope you're staying safe. Sending lots of love.
Bye. We look forward to seeing you.